back then, you know, KBOA was the station in southeast Missouri, and my mother and dad listened to it religiously after the war. We had a radio on at the house and there at McGuire, and I listened to that, and I loved country music. And back then, I had a little old Stella guitar, and I learned three chords on that thing, and I'd listen to KBOA. Because they had live people down there, live bands and all that stuff. And I used to slip off and play hooky and go to KBOA and press my nose up on the glass and watch these people perform. And when I got out of the service in 55, I got married first thing, was looking for a job as a radio announcer. So I went to Memphis and went to school down there at Keegan's Radio School. I went there about 6 or 8 months on the GI Bill. And that was in 55, early 56. I stopped at KBOA one day and told those guys, I want to be an announcer and I'm going to school to be one. And I talked to Johnny Mack and I don't know who all there, and they said, well, we don't have any openings right now, but we'll keep you in mind. So I took off to Florida on some whim and got down there and was there 5 or 6 months, and the phone rang one day, and KBOA called me and said, we got an opening on FM at night if you're interested. So I packed up my wife. Well, I sent her on the bus back to Missouri, and I came home in a 49 Ford convertible with all of our possessions in that old Ford with the rag top flopping in the wind, and stopped at KBOA and went to work there in 1956. One day Rudy Pilot said to me, I'm going down to Piggott and call on an advertiser down there, and this was in the daytime and I wasn't working, and he said, come go with me. We got down to Piggott and drove right on through there and kept going. I said, Rudy, where are we going? He said, we're going to Jonesboro. I've got you a job and you're going to go to college. I said, wait a minute. I'm married and got two kids. I can't go to college. I can't afford it. He said, yes, you can. I heard you tell one day that you had the GI Bill left. You had a whole bunch of that left. And there's a guy down there that's been listening to you now for about 2 or 3 weeks. It's the manager of KNEA, and he wants to hire you. And you can enroll in school and work at that station. And I said, gee, well, now wait, what a shock. So we went in the radio station in Jonesboro and went upstairs on an elevator above a bank. Harold Gregson was the manager down there then, and he hired me. And I enrolled in college and moved my family down there. And then I decided that I wanted to teach broadcasting on the college level. And so I went up to Missouri University and enrolled in school up there. And I worked there for about, I guess, 18 months or so. And I worked at the TV station, Channel 8. I was in the booth at night when my voice was on the air, you know, doing commercials. And Jack Parr was the nighttime guy on TV back in those days, and I put him to bed every night and signed off and go to school in the daytime. And I went back to KNEA in Jonesboro just to hang around until I could find something permanent. And I left there and went to Portageville and took over the management of that station in 1964. Hornersville used to have the Watermelon Festival. Well, old Jimmy Haggett booked Roy Orbison into there a year in advance. The day he came to perform, and Jimmy had him for just peanuts, you know, small amount of money, he had the number one record when he finally showed up there for the festival in the nation, Pretty Woman.